This may seem a little bizarre, but as I'm driving home to pick up my girls, we're talking about prayer. And, you know, one of the places I pray the most is in the car while I'm driving. One of the things I think we need to get away from thinking is that prayer has to be on your knees, in your bedroom, hands folded, or before dinner. It can be that. The more you think of prayer as a conversation, the more you think of prayer as something that can happen at any time, anywhere. It doesn't have to be long. It doesn't have to have certain words. It is a conversation with God. That's what it is. And when I drive, I have more time. I don't have people bugging me. I went, my praise car could be a joke of me. Our meeting last time, I got, like, everyone's saying, can I get this? Can I get this? Can I get this? I get interrupted by people. In your car, people aren't interrupting me. Now, maybe if I keep talking, I might get hit by someone, and that might interrupt me, but it's me and myself. And it provides another thing for me if I turn off the radio. One of the biggest things in prayer, too, is that too many times we don't shut up and listen for God. Do you ever feel like prayer is like a one-way street? Like you're the only one talking? Turn it on. And one of the reasons is because you are the only one talking. You don't let God speak. But you, this is your prayer. You'll say something like, dear Jesus, please be with me, blah, 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 amen. And then you're right on the next thing. Are you ever silent enough to hear him speak? Now, he may not audibly say something. You may never hear God audibly speak. I have never heard God audibly speak to me, ever. Some people do. God can do whatever he wants. He's a big God. But what I'm listening, what you listen for is the impression of the Spirit when you're saying things like, this is what I need to do, or this is what I don't need to do. And usually I know it's the Spirit because it's something I usually don't want to do. If it's, you know what, I need to be nicer to people, yeah, that's probably the Spirit. If it's, you know what, I need to care more, that's the Spirit. I need to confess to somebody. That's the Spirit. And it's usually the thing that I don't want to do. But how often do you shut up and listen in your prayer? In a place where you're not sleeping? I mean, why do we pray before we go to bed? I get it. But when you sit there and you're tired, it's 12:30 at night, you're laying in your sheets, of course you're going to be like, probably not the best thing to close my eyes while I'm driving. But seriously, when's the last time you just shut up and listen after you pray? Listen to hear what the Spirit's addressing. So I challenge you. If you're a freshman or sophomore, you can't drive, okay. But you rest of you guys, shut off the radio one morning. Say a little prayer. It doesn't have to be long. Just say something like, you know what? I don't want to do this day. I'm not a big fan of school sometimes. I just feel lost. Jesus, I need you. I need you. I have tried for years to serve you and it's just not working. I need you. And listen. And listen for what he prompts you, the Spirit to say. Listen for what he might put into your life. Maybe it's going to be like, you need to confess to somebody. Maybe it's, you just need to understand that God loves you. Maybe it's this idea that you need to understand what the cross is all about. The cross and the resurrection. Maybe it's going to be simple, something simple as you just need to be more kind. Use your cars. Listen. Shut up and listen to hear what Jesus has to say to you.